हेलो एवरीवन, वेलकम बैक टू एनसीईआरटी हिंदी ट्यूटर, योर अल्टीमेट डेस्टिनेशन फॉर क्लास 10 सीबीएसई एग्जाम प्रिपरेशंस। आई एम वैभव, योर होस्ट एंड गाइड, एंड टुडे वी हैव समथिंग ट्रूली स्पेशल लाइंड अप, अ कॉम्प्रिहेंसिव रिव्यू ऑफ द क्लास 10 सीबीएसई सोशल साइंस सैम्पल पेपर फॉर द अकेडमिक सेशन 2023 एंड 2024। स्ट्रेट फ्रॉम द सीबीएसई वेबसाइट, दिस सैम्पल पेपर इज पैक्ड विद इनसाइट्स टू हेल्प यू एक्सेल इन योर एग्जाम्स। Now, before we dive into the questions and answers, I want to take a moment to extend a warm welcome to all our viewers, especially those who may not be able to see. For you, my friends, I'll be reading out each question and its answers one by one, ensuring that everyone, regardless of visual ability, can fully engage with the content. And here's a handy tip for all our viewers. Did you know that you can change the subtitle language on YouTube according to your preference? If you are more comfortable with subtitles in Hindi or any other language, simply go to settings, choose your preferred language, and enhance your viewing experience. Now, whether you are a student gearing up for the exams or someone looking to enhance your social science knowledge, you are in the right place. Before we get started, make sure to hit that subscribe button and ring the bell to stay updated with our latest content. Now, let's embark on this learning journey together. CBSE Additional Practice Questions, Subject Social Science, Code 087, Class 10, 2023-24. Time allowed 3 hours, maximum marks 80. General Instructions. The question paper comprises of 6 sections A, B, C, D, E and F. There are 37 questions in the question paper. All questions are compulsory. Section A. From questions 1 to 20 are MCQs of 1 mark each. Section B. Question number 21 to 24 are very short answer type questions carrying 2 marks each. Answer to each question should not exceed 40 words. Section C contains question 25 to question 29 are short answer type questions carrying 3 marks each. Answer to each question should not exceed 60 words. Section D question number 30 to 33 are long answer type questions carrying 5 marks each. Answer to each question should not exceed 120 words. Section E question number from 34 to 36 are case-based questions with 3 sub-questions and are of 4 marks each. Answer to each question should not exceed 100 words. Section F. Question number 37 is map-based, carrying 5 marks with 2 parts. 37A from history, 2 marks, and 37B from geography, 3 marks. There is no overall choice in the question paper. However, an internal choice has been provided in few questions. Only one of the choices in such questions have to be attempted. In addition to this, separate instructions are given with each section and question wherever necessary. Section A, MCQs. Each question carry 1 mark, so section A carries 20 marks. Question 1. How was the Rowlatt Act of 1990 perceived in terms of fundamental rights and civil liberties by Indians? Answer B. It was considered as severely curtailing the right to personal liberty. Question 2. Ankur, a resident from Rajasthan, decided to install a submersible water pump in his house, capable of extracting groundwater from depths of 250 to 300 meters. This practice of installing similar pumps is becoming increasingly popular across the state. Which of the following will this growing practice most likely lead to in the near future? Answer D. Water scarcity resulting from excessive utilization. Question 3. Observe the map given below showing the distribution of thermal and nuclear power plants across India. Air Quality Index AQI is used to measure real-time air pollution levels. A high AQI represents poor air quality. Accordingly, which of the following regions marked on the map is likely to experience comparatively better AQI? Answer is C, R. So answer is R. The following question is for visually impaired students only in lieu of question 3. Which method of energy production is environmentally friendly and practical for powering homes across regions in India? Answer C. Solar power panels. Question 4. Trina, a 28-year-old woman from a marginalized community, is uneducated but adept at making traditional handicrafts. Her family toils hard to afford 2 square meals every day. Accordingly, which development objective would be the most crucial for improving Rina's and her kin's well-being? Answer C. creating more training opportunities for RINA and other artisans. Question 5. India's green energy goals have a serious problem. The Great Indian Bustard, a Wildlife Institute of India WII survey covering 80 km of power lines across the Thar Desert, found 4 bustard, critically endangered species, deaths during a single year due to high transmission wires, including some connected to wind turbines. Source: The Print. Should the installation of such power lines be reconsidered in areas where such species are found? Answer: Yes. Alternative methods of power generation should be explored to minimize this risk. Question 6. There are 2 statements given below, marked as assertion A and reason R. Read these statements and choose the correct option. Assertion A: Power sharing can help to prevent conflict in society. Reasoning R: Power sharing ensures that different social groups are included in decision-making processes, reducing marginalization and fostering inclusivity. Answer: C. Both A and R are true, and R explains A. Question 7. In an Indian state, communities X and Y have been engaged in a long-standing conflict over issues of coexistence and resource sharing. The tensions have intensified, leading to a demand from both communities for self-administration. What is the best resolution to this conflict? Answer: D. Establishing a power-sharing arrangement where both communities have a role in decision-making. Question 8. Which of the following is a definite indicator of the successful implementation of democratic governance? Answer: D. Establishment of institutions to protect people's rights. Question 9. There are 2 statements given below, marked as assertion A and reason R. Read these statements and choose the correct option. Assertion A: Self-help groups are instrumental in promoting economic democracy. Reasoning R: They contribute to a more equitable distribution of economic power and opportunities. Answer C. Both A and R are true, and R explains A. Question 10. The principle of subsidiarity emphasizes that decisions should be made by the people who are most affected by them, promoting decentralization, efficiency, and citizen participation in governance, with higher levels of authority intervening only when lower level authorities are unable to address certain issues effectively. Source: edited un.org. Which of the following constitutional principles, legislations, is in close alignment with the principles stated above? Answer: B. Division of power between the central, state and local government. Question 11. Globalization is the increasing interconnectedness of the world through the flow of goods, services, capital, ideas and people. Which of the following examples represents globalization? Answer: B. An IKEA store in Bengaluru selling products manufactured in China. Question 12. The Indian masses willingly participated in the civil disobedience movement, despite the challenges faced during the non-cooperation movement. Accordingly, which of the following quotes best reflects the outlook of the masses? Answer: A. The greatest glory in living lies not in never falling, but in rising every time we fall. Question 13. Given below is the painting Imperial Federation Map of the World showing the extent of the British Empire in 1886. Observe the painting and answer the question that follows. Source: exhibits.stanford.edu. Which of the following elements depicted in the painting seem conflicting when presented together? Answer: D. The words freedom and fraternity written at the top and atlas, depicting human labor holding the world upon his shoulders. Note: the following question is for visually impaired candidates only in lieu of question number 13. Read the information given below about the painting. A map celebrating the British Empire. The painting has a map that commemorates the British Empire, symbolizing its territorial holdings and influence across various regions of the world. Given below are a few elements that have been depicted in the painting. Identify the ones which are conflicting when presented together. Answer: A. The idea of freedom and imperialism. Question 14. There are 2 statements given below about the print revolution, marked as assertion A and reason R. Read these statements and choose the correct option. Assertion A: The distribution, application, and preservation of knowledge were fundamentally altered with the invention of printing. Reason R: printing enabled intellectuals to produce, comment on, and evaluate texts which spread as ideas across Europe? Answer C. Both A and R are true, and R explains A. Question 15. Which of the following is the primary factor which contributed to the emergence of multiple political parties at the same level in India? Answer C. Linguistic and regional diversity. Question 16. Which of the following policy decisions by the central government could potentially serve as a trade barrier? Answer C. Implementing higher tariffs on imports. Question 17. Given below is a cartoon created by Neelab Banerjee, the renowned Indian cartoonist, illustrator, and comics artist. Oh, she doesn't work, she is a housewife. Source: asiapacific.unwomen.org. What is the cartoon trying to depict? Answer A. The sexual division of labor in India. Note, the following question is for visually impaired candidates only in lieu of question number 17. In a cartoon created by Neelab Banerjee, the renowned Indian cartoonist, illustrator, and comics artist, a woman is depicted in rural setting, carrying water pots on her head and a bundle of sticks in her hands. She is also holding her child's hand. Meanwhile, a man, presumably her husband, is seen lying on a cot. The husband is heard saying, "Oh, she doesn't work. She is just a housewife." What is the cartoon trying to depict? Answer A. The sexual division of labor in India. Question 18. The table given below highlights the percentage of workers in the three sectors of the economy in India. The data for the year 2023 has actual figures, while the data for 2040 is hypothetical based on the published figures of the year 2023. Any of the three hypothetical scenarios could be possible in the year 2040. Study the table carefully and answer the questions that follow. Year, primary, secondary, tertiary. 2023, source Statista. Primary 44%, secondary 25%, tertiary 31%. 2040, hypothetical scenario 1, primary 20%, secondary 45%, tertiary 35%. 2040, hypothetical scenario 2, primary 60%, secondary 20%, tertiary 20%. 2040, hypothetical scenario 3, primary 15%, secondary 40%, tertiary 45%. With all other factors remaining the same, which of the following scenarios would have the biggest impact on India's global leadership in the future? Answer D. Either hypothetical scenario 1 or 3. Question 19. Based on the information given in the table, which of the following statements is likely to be correct? Answer D. In scenarios 1 and 3, maximum employment opportunities will be created in the secondary sector. Question 20. In a representative democracy, which of the following best describes the role of the elected representatives? Answer B. They are accountable to the public and make decisions on behalf of their constituents. We have completed section A. Let's move on to section B. Very short answer type questions, and each question carry 2 marks. Question 21. Consumer Affairs raids Malda markets to check malpractices. Complaints were received that soft drinks were being sold at higher price. Source edited Millennium Post. First, which consumer right was being violated in the above instance of soft drinks being sold at higher price? Answer, right to be informed. Second, which consumer right was likely invoked in the response to the complaints? Answer, right to seek redressal. Question 22. Shruti performed a web search for teacher and found that 80% of the images had women, while a search for pilot mainly showed men. Discuss how these web search results reflect societal perceptions and the sexual division of labor. Explain with an example. Answer: the overrepresentation of women as teachers and men as pilots reinforce traditional notions of job roles. The role of teaching is considered a caregiving job suitable for women, while the role of pilot is regarded as a physically and mentally demanding job ideal for men. Similarly, the job of a nurse is associated more with women, and the job of an engineer is associated with men. These trends represent social perceptions and perpetuate sexual division of labor. Question 23. Examine the possible consequences on the basic right of party members within political organizations that lack internal democracy. Answer: freedom of speech and expression, पार्टी वर्कर्स में फेस रिस्ट्रिक्शंस ऑन वॉइसिंग देयर ओपिनियंस आइडियाज और कंसर्न्स विद इन द पार्टी स्ट्रक्चर राइट टू इक्वालिटी ऑफ अपॉर्चुनिटी नॉट एवरी वन वुड गेट एन इक्वल चांस टू क्लाइंब अप द सक्सेस लैडर एनी अदर रेलिवेंट पॉइंट और इन अ हाइपोथेटिकल डेमोक्रेटिक नेशन विद अ पॉपुलेशन डेट इज रिलीजियसली होमोजीनियस शुड देयर स्टिल बी मल्टीपल पॉलिटिकल पार्टीज जस्टिफाई योर स्टांस इन अबाउट 40 वर्ड्स Answer, yes, because despite a religiously homogeneous population, having multiple political parties helps represent diverse political perspectives, helps in policy formation, helps avoid authoritarianism, provides an alternative to the voters, any other relevant point. Question 24, assess the reasons for the concentration of the woolen textile industries in the subtropical region in India versus their absence in the southern part of India. Answer, climatic conditions. Southern India has a climate which is not favorable for wool production. Lack of raw material. Sheep rearing is not widespread in southern India. Low demand. The demand for woolen textiles is very low in southern India due to hot and humid temperatures. Any other relevant point? All these requirements are met in the subtropical region of India. Hence, the woolen textile industry is concentrated in this region of India. Friends, we have completed section B. Now let's move on to section C. Short answer based questions carrying 3 marks each. Question 25. A drought induced water shortage can have far reaching consequences affecting agriculture productivity, the availability of food resources, industrial activities and livelihoods, thereby significantly impacting human well-being. First, what does the above statement represent about the relationship between different resources? Answer, it represents the interconnectedness and the interdependence between resources. Availability of food resources depends on water and a negative impact on agriculture would affect livelihoods, impacting a human resource. Second, how does such a situation represent lack of resource planning? Answer, the situation represents lack of water management and over-reliance on monsoons. Question 26. Discuss the most likely impact of India operated without a federal system. Build the answer around these points. Regional autonomy, effectiveness in governance, decision-making process. Answer. First, regional autonomy. Regional governments would have little or no decision-making power. Regional aspirations might get suppressed. Second, effectiveness of governance. Local issues might not receive due attention, leading to a disconnect between grassroots reality and governance. Third, decision-making process. The decision-making process might become undemocratic and less inclusive. It is likely to neglect regional aspirations. Any other relevant point? Question 27. Read the statements given below regarding Indian Railways. Statement 1, S1. Indian Railways has largely been a public sector enterprise. Statement 2, S2. Private players are making an entry into the Indian Railway market. Explain what trend do these statements S1 and S2 reflect in the railway sector in India. Answer. It represents a growing trend of public-private partnership in the Indian market. With private trains running, the service quality and the customer experience would be enhanced. It would lead to diversification of choices for the Indian masses. It would also lead to an investment in the public infrastructure. But it would also lead to railways becoming unaffordable for the common masses. It would also result in revenue loss for the government. Question 28. Which sector, organized or unorganized, is preferable for employment? Explain. Answer. It is a preference that might depend on a variety of factors. People might prefer to work in the organized sector because of job security, social security benefits, regular income. People might prefer to work in the unorganized sector because of flexibility, escaping paperwork, quick employment opportunity. Question 29. Discuss the role of newspapers in shaping public opinion and the democratization of information during the modern period. Answer. It led to dissemination of information. It served as a platform for shaping public discourse. It led to increased awareness about social, political and economic issues. Any other relevant point? We have completed section C. Now we will proceed to section D. Long answer based questions carrying 5 marks each. Question 30. examine the significance and key milestones of the civil disobedience movement that took place in India during the struggle for independence. Answer: key milestones. Dandi March. Gandhi's 240-mile march to Dandi to produce salt became a powerful symbol of resistance and gained international attention. Repression and imprisonment. British authorities responded with the repression and arrest, fueling public outrage and strengthening the movement. Negotiations and outcomes. The movement led to negotiations between Congress and the British government but fell short of full independence. Significance. Mass participation. The movement witnessed widespread involvement from diverse segments of society, showcasing unity and determination. Boycott of British goods. Indians boycotted British products to promote self-reliance and protest colonial economic policies. Spread of nationalist ideas. The movement raised awareness, inspired active participation, and fostered national unity among the masses. Legacy and inspiration. The movement's legacy as a symbol of non-violent resistance inspired future freedom fighters worldwide. Or read the following excerpt about the right to protest in India and answer the question that follows. The Constitution of India guarantees the fundamental right to protest, which is derived from the broader rights of freedom of speech and expression, and freedom to assemble peacefully. However, this right is subject to reasonable restrictions in the interest of India's sovereignty. Violent actions during protests are in violation of citizens' fundamental duties, emphasizing that the right to protest encompasses only peaceful demonstrations. Source: Legal Service India. Examine the elements of satyagraha employed during the 20th century Indian freedom struggle in light of their alignment with the right to protest granted by the Indian Constitution as mentioned in the passage. Answer: the elements of satyagraha that align with the right to protest of present times include non-violence, peaceful protests, respect for human rights, and emphasis on dialogue and negotiation. These aspects promote democratic values, freedom of speech, and the right to dissent. However, there are certain elements of satyagraha that may go against the Indian Constitution. For example, acts of civil disobedience that involve breaking laws or disrupting public order can be seen as conflicting with the principle of upholding the rule of law. Additionally, satyagraha techniques that obstruct essential services or hinder the functioning of government machinery may be deemed unconstitutional. Question 31. A think tank has been given the task to design an outline to measure how successful has democracy been in any country. Discuss the key indicators that the think tank should consider while designing this outline and explain why these factors are crucial in assessing the outcomes of democracy. Answer: free and fair elections. This represents a healthy democratic process in place. Second point, citizens' right to information. This is important since only after having the right information can the citizens hold the government accountable. Third, protection of minority rights. This represents a strong commitment to democratic principles as this would enable the minority community to participate in the decision-making processes. Fourth, poverty. Reduction in poverty over the years would indicate the successful implementation of democracy. Fifth, rule of law. Presence of institutions like an independent judiciary helps uphold law and ensures fairness, justice, and equal treatment to citizens. Any other relevant point? Or, free and fair media is one of the most important outcomes of democracy. Comment. Answer: a democratic government needs to be an accountable, responsive, and legitimate government. It needs to ensure that it has enabled its citizens to participate in the decision-making processes. It has to make sure that its citizens are informed and making informed choices. It needs to make sure that it is accommodating varied perspectives. Media as a fourth pillar helps fulfill all these objectives of a democratic government, and hence it is one of the most important outcomes of democracy. Question 32. Describe circumstances that drive individuals to seek loans from informal source of credit. Answer: immediate financial requirement, absence of collateral, unavailability of documents, informal economy and irregular income, limited, restricted access to formal sources of credit. Any other relevant point? Or state the potential negative economic implications that would arise in an economy in the absence of the concept of credit? Answer: limited access to funds for starting businesses or making investments, limited capacity of savings, limited ability to finance education and skill development, limited ability to purchase very high worth items like car, houses, etc., limited financial flexibility and convenience, any other relevant point. Question 33. Read the information given below regarding Delhi-Dehradun Expressway and answer the question that follows. The Delhi-Dehradun Expressway is all set to open to the public by the end of 2023. It would reduce the travel time between the two cities from 6 to 2 hours. The 210-kilometer long expressway will start from northeast Delhi and pass through Baghpat, Shamli, Muzaffarnagar, Saharanpur and Dehradun. The last 20-kilometer stretch will pass through the eco-sensitive zone of Raja Ji National Park, where Asia's longest elevated wildlife corridor of 6 lanes and 12 kilometers will be constructed. That includes the 340-meter Dat Kali Tunnel. The 340-meter long tunnel near Dat Kali Temple, Dehradun, will help reduce the impact on wildlife, and multiple animal passes have been provided in the Ganeshpur-Dehradun section for avoiding animal vehicle collisions. Source edited LiveMint. Analyze the development of the Delhi-Dehradun Expressway in terms of its impact, negative and or positive, on economic growth, the environment and the goal of sustainable development. Answer: economic growth. Reduced travel time will boost trade and tourism, can lead to greater investment in the valley. The construction itself is leading to the generation of employment opportunities. Environment: passing through an eco-sensitive zone will lead to loss of flora and fauna. Increased vehicular emissions will lead to increased pollution. Sustainable development: environmental concerns have been taken into account and wildlife corridors have been built. Green construction methods could solve the problem of carbon emissions. Or, as per Britannica dictionary, when the world is seen as a community in the which people are connected by computers, television, etc., and all depend on one another, the world becomes a global village. Accordingly, they elaborate on the role of air transport in making the world a global village. Answer: accessibility. Air transport has significantly improved accessibility to distant locations, making it a convenient mode of travel in cases where other means of transportation are impractical. Second, facilitating international trade. Supply chains have been revolutionized by the quick movement of cargo by air, enabling companies to easily access international markets. Now, time-sensitive shipments, high-value commodities, and perishable goods can all be delivered quickly, which has boosted global trade. Third, boosting tourism. People from different countries can now explore new destinations, experience diverse cultures, and build connections with individuals from around the world. This exposure had led to a better understanding of various traditions and customs, promoting cross-cultural appreciation. Fourth, advancing business and diplomacy. Face-to-face meetings, conferences, and negotiations between individuals and representatives from different nations are now more feasible, fostering collaboration and cooperation. This has been crucial in promoting international business ventures and resolving global issues. Humanitarian aid and crisis response. During emergencies, natural disasters, or humanitarian crises, air transport enables the swift delivery of relief supplies, medical assistance, and rescue teams to affected areas. This quick response saves numerous lives and provides vital support during time of distress. Any other relevant point? We have completed section D. Now we will proceed to section E, case-based question, which carry 4 marks each. Question 34. Read the information about climate smart agriculture and answer the question that follows. Climate Smart Agriculture (CSA) is an approach that helps guide actions to transform agri-food systems towards green and climate-resilient practices. CSA supports reaching internationally agreed goals such as the Sustainable Development Goals and the Paris Agreement on Climate Change. CSA supports the Food and Agriculture Organization Strategic Framework 2022-2031 based on the four betters: better production, better nutrition, a better environment, and a better life for all, leaving no one behind. सोर्स एडिटेड फूड एंड एग्रीकल्चर ऑर्गेनाइजेशन. क्वेश्चन वन, अ CSA एक्सपर्ट सजेस्टेड इंक्रीज प्रोडक्शन एंड कंजम्पशन ऑफ मिलेट्स इन इंडिया, जस्टिफाई देयर स्टांस. आंसर, मिलेट्स हैव हाई न्यूट्रिशनल वैल्यू, दे आर रेन फेड, हार्डली नीड एनी इरीगेशन फैसिलिटीज एंड हैंस कैन बी ग्रोन इन एरिड एंड सेमी एरिड रीजन्स. मिलेट्स डू नॉट रिक्वायर अ लॉट ऑफ इन्वेस्टमेंट टू फ्लोरिश, विच कैन हेल्प देम बी अ ग्रेट कमर्शियल ग्रेन सब्स्टिट्यूट्स इन प्रॉपर नेशंस. सेकेंड, वट इज द नेसेसिटी टू थिंक ऑफ CSA इन इंडिया. आंसर, इट इज़ इम्पॉर्टेंट टू स्टार्ट प्लानिंग फॉर CSA इन इंडिया बिकॉज ऑफ द चेंजिंग क्लाइमेट ड्यू टू ग्लोबल वार्मिंग. थर्ड, सजेस्ट टू मैथड्स थ्रू विच इंडिया कैन शिफ्ट टूअर्ड्स CSA. आंसर, यूज ऑफ जेनेटिकली मॉडिफाइड सीड्स रेजिस्टेंट टू इंसेक्ट डैमेज फॉर क्रॉपिंग, शिफ्ट टूअर्ड्स ऑर्गेनिक एंड नेचुरल फार्मिंग मैथड्स, एनी अदर रेलिवेंट पॉइंट. क्वेश्चन 35, रीड द पैसेज गिवन बिलो एंड आंसर द क्वेश्चंस फॉलोड. पॉपुलेशन ट्रेंड्स एंड डायनेमिक्स कैन हैव एन इनॉर्मस इफेक्ट ऑन प्रॉस्पेक्ट्स फॉर पॉवर्टी रिडक्शन एंड सस्टेनेबल डेवलपमेंट. पॉवर्टी इज इन्फ्लुएंस्ड बाय एंड इन्फ्लुएंसेस पॉपुलेशन डायनेमिक्स इंक्लूडिंग पॉपुलेशन ग्रोथ, एज स्ट्रक्चर एंड रूरल अर्बन डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन. ऑल ऑफ दिस हैज़ अ क्रिटिकल इम्पैक्ट ऑन अ कंट्रीज डेवलपमेंट प्रॉस्पेक्ट्स एंड प्रॉस्पेक्ट्स फॉर रेजिंग लिविंग स्टैंडर्ड्स फॉर द पुअर. Investments in better health, including reproductive health, are essential for individual security and for reducing mortality and morbidity, the condition of suffering from a disease or medical condition, which in turn improve a country's productivity and development prospects. Source: UNFPA. First, how does investing in improved healthcare infrastructure contribute to the reduction of preventable diseases and chronic conditions? Answer. Investments in better healthcare provide people with access to essential healthcare services such as vaccinations, prenatal care, and treatment for common diseases. This can help to reduce the number of people who die from preventable diseases, mortality, and who suffer from chronic conditions, morbidity. Second, explain the relationship between population trends and poverty reduction. Answer. An expanding population can exert pressure on a country's resources, including food, water, and land, which can consequently result in heightened poverty levels as individuals may face insufficient access to nourishment and adequate housing. Third, poverty is influenced by and influences population dynamics, including population growth, age structure, and rural-urban distribution. Analyze the statement and highlight the mutual relationship between poverty and population. Answer. Population growth can strain resources and infrastructure, potentially increasing poverty. The age structure of a population affects labor markets and social support systems, which can impact poverty levels. Rural-urban distribution determines access to essential services and economic opportunities, further influencing poverty rates. Poverty can contribute to specific population dynamics such as high fertility rates and limited access to healthcare, perpetuating the cycle of poverty. Any other relevant point? Question 36. Read the following lines from Gandhiji's address at the AICC All India Congress Committee in Bombay on 8-8-42 outlining his plan of action in Hindustani and answer the questions that follow. You may take it from me that I am not going to strike a bargain with the Viceroy for ministries and the like. I am not going to be satisfied with anything short of complete freedom. Maybe he will propose the abolition of the salt tax, the drink evil, etc. But I will say nothing less than freedom. Here is a mantra, a short one, that I give you. You may imprint it on your hearts and let every breath of yours give expression to it. The mantra is do or die. We shall either free India or die in the attempt. We shall not live to see the perpetuation of our slavery. Every true congressman or woman will join the struggle with an inflexible determination not to remain alive to see the country in bondage and slavery. Let that be your pledge. Keep jails out of your consideration. Source: Smithsonian Magazine. First, explain any one key impact that Gandhiji's rejection of striking a bargain with the Viceroy for ministries and the like Add on the people participating in the freedom struggle. Answer: People joined the freedom struggle with stronger determination and pledged not to live to see the perpetuation of India's slavery. Any other relevant point? Second, how did this mantra differ from earlier strategies employed in the struggle for the independence? Answer: The movement aimed at achieving complete independence without accepting any concessions or partial freedoms from the British government. Earlier strategies, such as non-violent civil disobedience and negotiation, focused on pressing the British government to grant incremental reforms and concessions. The do-or-die approach, in contrast, signaled a departure from the quest for piecemeal changes and instead demanded immediate and complete freedom for India. Third, discuss the economic context and political climate that led to the adoption of the do-or-die mantra. Answer: During the freedom struggle, the failure of the British government to fulfill promises of granting dominion status to India after World War II left Indian leaders disillusioned with incremental reforms. The movement was triggered by discontent among Indians due to the harsh impacts of the war on the economy and living conditions. The political climate in India was tense, with growing impatience for complete independence. Mahatma Gandhi, advocating non-violent civil disobedience, sought a more decisive strategy to break the stalemate in negotiations with the British. Friends, we have completed section E. Now let's move on to section F, map skill based question. Question 37A. Two places A and B have been marked on the given outline map of India. Identify them and write their correct names on the lines drawn near them. First, the place where the Jallianwala Bagh massacre took place. Answer: Amritsar, Punjab. Second, the 1927 Indian National Congress session was held at this place. Answer: Madras. 37B. On the same map of India, locate and label any three of the following with suitable symbols. First, a dam built on the river Satluj. Answer: Bhakra Nangal Dam. Second, a software technology park in northern India. Answer: Noida. Third, southernmost port on the east coast of India. Answer: Tuticorin. Fourth, a nuclear power plant in the state of Maharashtra. Answer: Tarapur. Note, the following question is for visually impaired candidates only in lieu of question 37 part A and part B. A. Name the place where the Jallianwala Bagh massacre took place. Answer: Punjab. Second, name the place where the Indian National Congress session was held in 1927. Answer: Maharashtra. B. The following question is for visually impaired candidates only in lieu of question number 37B. Answer any three of the following. Name the dam built on the river Satluj. Answer: Bhakra Nangal Dam. Second, name the place in northern India where an important software technology park is present. Answer: Noida. Third, name the southernmost port on the east coast of India. Answer: Tuticorin. Fourth, name the nuclear power plant present in the state of Maharashtra. Answer: Tarapur Atomic Power Plant. And there you have it, a detailed exploration of the Class 10 CBSE Social Science sample paper for the session 2023-24. I hope this video has been a valuable resource for your exam preparation. If you found it helpful, don't forget to give it a thumbs up and share it with your friends. For more insightful content like this, make sure to subscribe to NCERT Hindi Tutor and join our vibrant community. If you have any questions or specific topics you would like to cover in future videos, drop them in the comments below. I am Vaibhav, signing off for now. Best of luck with your studies, and until next time, happy learning.